हेलो फ्रेंड्स, होप यू आर गुड। दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर सेकेंड ऑफ ऑटो एचवैक टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लुक इनटू द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ हीटिंग, वेंटिलेशन एंड एयर कंडीशनिंग। सो लेट गेट स्टार्टेड विद दिस सेशन। सो हियर आर द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ हीटिंग, वेंटिलेशन एंड एयर कंडीशनिंग। व्हाइल डिजाइनिंग ऑफ योर ऑटोमोबाइल एचवैक, यू नीड टू बी हाईलाइट सम पॉइंट्स। ओके, सो दीज आर द फ्यू पॉइंट्स आई हैव मेंशन over these slides. So let's take a look on one by one. The first one is, it should allow the atmospheric air which is filtered to be entered inside the cabin. Okay, it is very much important to allow the filtered air, as you know that there is a lot of pollutions and the contamination content in the air of this atmosphere. So for getting inside the air, it must be a filtered. Okay, then the second requirement is, it should remove the stale. The word stale means lacking of freshness air, by replacing the filtered fresh air. So it is very important to replace the fresh air with the stale air, and stale air with the filtered fresh air. The third one is, it should be circulate the air pool through the inside the vehicle via ducts and outlets in the summer condition. It should circulate the cool air through the inside. So as you know that there is a four chambers or four seats are available in the general automobiles. So it must be, you have to provide the duct for having the fresh air or cool air on your feet, on your face area, or it should be a throughout circulation. Okay, so there is a panel is available there. So by switching the switches, you can circulate this cool air on your feet, on your face, or throughout the cabin in summer condition. Okay, as you know that in summer condition you need cool air. On the opposite side, in winter season you need hot air. So it circulates the hot air throughout the inside the vehicle via ducts and outlets in the winter condition. Okay, so these two requirements are very much important from your season wise conditions. Okay, summer condition and the winter condition. In summer condition you need cool air, in winter condition you need hot air. Then the next one is, it should maintain the human comfort conditions. In previous lectures I have explained about all the human conditions. So if you haven't watched it, please go through this lecture number first. Then another requirement of designing heating, ventilation and air conditioning system, it must be a less noise of this system. Then it must not be produce any odor or bad odor, it so that it must be a odorless. It must be a harmless, that refrigerant, or this refrigerant is nothing but the fluid which is flowing inside the your system. So it must not be harmless, sorry, it must not be harmful to the passengers which are seated in the vehicle. So it must be harmless. Then also it must be a cost effective, which is an important factor for this operation of this HVAC system. As you know that the when you operate the AC system of your vehicle, it must be directly affect your vehicle average. Okay, because it consumes some energy from the engine. So this requirement is very much important. It should not produce any noise, it must be odorless, it must be harmful less, then it must be a cost effective. So these are the some requirements you should keep in your mind while designing the heating, ventilation and air conditioning systems. So in this session we have gone through the requirements of HVAC systems. If you have any doubts about this session, you can ask me. in the comment section box or in your Google Classroom.